Namaste everyone, this is Dr. Pratibha K.S. Head, Department of Biotechnology at KLE Societies, S. Jingappa College, Rajaji Nagar, Bengaluru. Today I'm before you to present a lecture talk on structural organization of protein, that is quaternary structure. This quaternary structure can also be known as oligomeric proteins or quaternary structure. Okay, here you can see the presence of two or more polypeptide chains can be seen. Here, alignment of many protein subunits forming a multi-subunit structure. In this quaternary structure, individual polypeptide chains are known as subunits. Okay, proteins that contain more than one polypeptide chains display an additional complex structural level of organization known as quaternary structure. Okay, and also known as oligomeric proteins. These oligomeric proteins exhibit a quaternary structure. Oligo means few. Okay, few polypeptide chains can be seen in the quaternary structure of few protein molecules. They reveal the orientation of different chains with respect to each other. Okay, these chains are held together by non-covalent interactions of two or more polypeptide chains. Depending on the number of subunits, such proteins are called dimers. Dimers means presence of two polypeptide chain, tetramers, four polypeptide chain, and polymers, many polypeptide chains can be seen. For example, hemoglobin, which is tetramer, where you can see the presence of four polypeptide chains, is also known as oligomeric proteins. It is an oxygen transport oligomeric protein present in the blood of vertebrates. Okay, in hemoglobin, you can see the presence of four polypeptide chains, each with heme. Heme, which is a prosthetic group. Prosthetic group means non-protein part of the protein. Okay, with a ferrose, Fe2+, and four chains which are held together by non-covalent interactions in a particular geometric arrangement. Okay, the hemoglobin structure similar to myoglobin. With myoglobin, it stands for oxygen transferring muscle. If the protein molecule consists of identical subunits, it is said to have homogeneous quaternary structure. For example, lactate dehydrogenase. Okay, if the subunits are dissimilar, the protein is said to have a heterogeneous quaternary structure or heterooligomeric protein. For example, hemoglobin. In hemoglobin, you will find two alpha chains and two beta chains. You can see here two alpha chains and two beta chains can be seen. In this hemoglobin, you can see each hemoglobin which carries four heme molecules. Okay, then they'll carry four oxygen molecules. One, this hemoglobin molecule which conjugate with oxygen, known as oxygenated hemoglobin. Okay, here you can see three-dimensional structure of the hemoglobin, whereas here, okay, hemoglobin, it is oxygen transport oligomeric protein present in blood of vertebrates. Okay, it is a tetramer. Okay, where you can see the presence of four polypeptide chain, okay, two alpha chains and two beta chains. All these four subunits interact with each other. Okay, one subunit, second subunit, third subunit, fourth subunit. All these four subunits which interact with each other to produce quaternary structure of hemoglobin. Okay, here you can see different structural organization can be seen over here. Helix condition or maybe Shipley operation can also be seen. Okay, the linear sequence of amino acid in a polypeptide chain with its peptide linkage presents the primary structure. Okay, this is about the primary structure representation. Then the folding or coiling of linear polypeptide chain into alpha helix or beta pleated represents its secondary structure. Then three-dimensional configuration showing the bending and entwining, that is wind or twist, wind, okay, entwining, wind or twist of these alpha helix or beta pleated sheets with each other represents the tertiary structure. The last one is quaternary structure, where you can see the interaction of many polypeptide chains, and based on nature of such entwined units in the entire protein molecule represents the quaternary structure. So this is all about the just definition about the primary structure, then secondary structure, tertiary structure, and quaternary structure. You must also keep in your mind about the chaperonins, are proteins that provide favorable conditions for the correct folding of other proteins, thus preventing aggregation. Here, these chaperonins belong to a large class of molecules that assist protein folding, called molecular chaperones. The energy to fold proteins is supplied by adenosine triphosphate. In the exam, they've asked you these chaperones for 2 marks or 1 mark, you can write. Okay. Here you can see the general structure of amino acid. In general structure of amino acid, we can see center, that is alpha carbon atom or chiral carbon atom, one side hydrogen, other side functional group, RR chain, a side chain, another side amino group, another side carboxyl group. Okay, due to the presence of both amino and carboxyl, known this particular this structure as amino acids. Here you can see 20 different types of amino acids. Their R group, only R group were mentioned here. This R group will be attached here. Okay, this valine group will be here, then leucine group will be here. Okay, only side chains were written here. Okay, all the 20 amino acids are differentiated into non-polar R groups, polar R groups, negatively charged R groups, and positively charged R groups. Now let us go through biological importance of proteins. Proteins which are useful to biological systems. Many proteins act as catalyst, right? Thus enhancing the rate of chemical reactions. The fibrous proteins serve as components of the tissue holding the skeletal elements together. For example, collagen is a major connective tissue. The nucleoproteins serve as carriers of genetic characters and hence concerned with inheritance of traits. Proteins also perform transport functions, for example, that is through hemoglobin. Various protein hormones regulate the growth of plants and animals, besides controlling many physiological functions. Proteins inside the cell provide toxicity, for example, venoms of snake and insects biting, the release of their proteins into the blood cause death. Why? That is due to certain foreign substances present in venom or enzymes like lecithinase. We have lecithin structure. When these lecithinase enzyme which enter inside the body system, okay, there you can see the formation of isolecithin molecule. These enzymes attack body tissues carrying the destructions of blood cells leading to death. Interferon is a cellular protein that the body naturally produces in response to virus infection. It is said to be effective in treating virus disease. Here you can see, till now studied levels of organization of proteins. Okay, primary structure, where you could see the linear polypeptide chain. Each amino acids which are joined together by the peptide bonds. Okay, strong covalent peptide bond can be seen. Okay, further in structural hierarchy of the proteins, we can see secondary structure. Okay, there are two different types of secondary structure, that is, one is alpha helix, right? Alpha helix, other one is the beta pleated sheets. Okay, another one is the beta pleated sheets. Other than beta pleated sheets, even you will come across with the triple helix and beta bend, but we abundantly found which is the alpha helix and the beta pleated sheets. Alpha helix again stabilized by the hydrogen bond. These hydrogen bond interactions will stabilize this particular neurotic configuration of alpha helix. Whereas here also you can see the presence of hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bonds will stabilize this native configuration of beta pleated sheets. And next is tertiary structure. Okay, here tertiary structure, foldings and refoldings can be seen here. In the tertiary structure, you can see almost all the different types of bonds can be seen here. Okay, like hydrogen bond, then disulfide bond, ionic bond, okay, and hydrophobic bonds can be seen. Whereas this, the quaternary structure, macro structure or larger structure, here you can see more than one polypeptide chain or more than one protein which associate with each other to form a quaternary structure. Okay, these are all about the structural hierarchy of the proteins. Hope you understood today's concept, protein organization, structural structure, and their functions of the proteins. Okay, thank you for watching and thank you for being with me. Thank you.